Arts for their great effort in producing a wonderful poem on outstanding annual international scientific meeting. I think we are so lucky because it's a time for one of the interesting lecture for one of the most outstanding pathologists. He's the most famous pathologist not only in the United States but also in all the world. He is Dr. Roba Ali, and his topic is about sex for the stromal tumor.
So much. Thank you for that introduction. Truly appreciate it. And again, one more time, it's a pleasure being here. And believe me, I get energy from you, and I love being here. And it is wonderful, and I apologize if I had to run quick just to rest a little bit. I thought I'm younger than what I am, actually, because I thought, oh, it'll be a piece of cake. I can stand here for the whole day. Well, apparently I get tired, so my voice was a little bit cracky at the end, and I felt that the sugar in my blood is going down, which is why I thought, no, I need to go and sit a little bit. But I'll be here in the break, and I'll take all the questions. Hopefully I will not use the chair, but just I thought, just in case. You know, if I really get tired, I can sit. I have the sugar, so I'm all set. In the next 3 hours, I'll go straight 3 hours, and then my colleague will give the immunohistochemistry, chemistry, I believe, and problematic cases for breast cancer. But just to keep the theme, hopefully I can stand for the next 3 hours and shift to ovary. We covered the clear cell, and we'll do the sex for stromal tumor. I was planning to do it at the end, but we'll start with it. That's okay. It's not my favorite tumor, but no problem. You know, based on demand, I'll start with that. And then we'll move to the serous borderline and the very serous borderline tumor. So let me shift gears and. I put together like an overview of the sex for stromal tumor. And before I start, truly thanks for the book. This is really precious. That's so wonderful. You have a great material, and if you have the data and the cases, that's a precious material to start any collaboration with us, with me, with Genarula. It would be wonderful. Any institute in the state would love to, you know, collaborate with you, and it would be a pleasure again to work with you. Thanks so much. So, sex for stromal tumor of the ovary. It's a spectrum of things based on the WH classification. There's so many, and no way in 40 minutes I can cover them. This is what's in the WHO. And I'll try to get like a glimpse of like few interesting points on each one and quick differential diagnosis. So we start with the benign one, the fibromatosarcoma. Fibroma, and it might be cellular, mitotically active fibrocyte. The next one, granulosa cell tumor. Adult androgynon, Sertoli cell tumor, and Sertoli Leydig cell tumor, and the mixed and classified tumor. And this is quick, the way they present, and which one is more prominent. Fibroma, it is so well circumscribed, and grossly, most of the time you will not miss it. It's a white, glistening cut section. It's similar to leiomyoma, but it's more firm even. And it is very common, especially rarely you see it before 30 years of old, predominantly in elderly, and associated with Meigs syndrome. I remember when I was taking my board, and I did also a review for the board, they love these syndromes. How many times you've seen it? Eventually rated Meigs syndrome. It is the pleural effusion and ascites. and it is associated with another syndrome, the BCC, the Nevoid BCC syndrome, 80% bilateral. And you see that spectrum between fibroma or trichoma or in between, whenever I'm in doubt, is it like crucial to be to miss the trichomatous aspect of it? Could be fibrotrichoma. You know, it's not a big deal. And predominantly it is this spindle, and different from leiomyoma. Leiomyoma, it's more cigar shape. I call it, it's more elegant. This is more twisted and more whirly. And the stroma, the background slightly different. These are like more with a little bit glutenized here. Orange red, oh, it needs to be fresh from, you know, fresh specimen to do it. Do we do it? No, I don't know if you do it. There are cellular fibroma, and the main differential diagnosis fibrosarcoma. It used to be that any mitosis, you'll call it fibrosarcoma. This is not true. Okay, there is something called cellular fibroma, and it is mitotically slightly active, no significant cytologic activity, and it is similar to borderline. So it might recur, okay? But it is still in the benign aspect. Fibrosarcoma are vanishingly rare, and you need more than 10 mitosis per 10 high power field and a significant activity. So for me, any sarcoma, I need the three entity that I told you about, mitosis, significant cytologic activity, and the necrosis. Then I'll be comfortable calling it, and it works in any organ, not only in the leiomyosarcoma. So without having the significant psychologic activity, even with the mitosis, I won't call it. And remember, it's eventually rare. So do not, I mean, I've seen only two cases. Okay? So think about the cellular fibroma before calling fibrosarc. Differential diagnosis, leiomyoma. And I've seen it in the ovary. It is less common. It's more common to see fibroma. But wherever you are in doubt, I would put the actin and tell that on the specimen. This is the cellular, I lost my pointer. The cellular fibroma, and it is mitotically active, as you can see in the arrows. This is a little different, like differentiation between the adult granulosa cell tumor, Sertoli Leydig cell tumor, and Sertoli cell tumor. The main age, and all of these tumors, when it present, it's unilateral most of the time, almost 90% unilateral adnexal mass. And most of these patients are young. The common presentation, the adult granulosa cell tumor, is estrogenic, Sertoli Leydig cell tumor androgenic, and the Sertoli cell tumor is estrogenic. Most of them, they present in stage one, and time to recur, it varies. It is, the Sertoli cell tumor is up to 3 years, and granulosa cell tumors sort of present late in life. It's not, you know, within 1 year. Moving to granulosa cell tumor, this neoplasm shows the differentiation toward the follicular granulosa cell, and it is 2% of the ovarian neoplasm. And remember, there are two types, the juvenile type and the adult type. The juvenile type, from its name, it presents in younger patients. The adult, it can present in young and elderly. It's not only in the older patient. Okay? Morphology, they are slightly different, and watch is different. There are so many variants. Do I have to put it in my report? No, I don't, but I have to recognize it. I have to recognize all of this for the differential diagnosis. So there are diffuse type, trabecular, insular, microfollicular, macrofollicular, and water cell, and gyriform. And sometimes you'll see more than one variant. We did a study to look at these variants. It did not affect prognosis. Okay, so just for the sake of looking at all of this variant, the insular type, look at this, it is a granulosa cell tumor and small cells uniform with scant cytoplasm, diffuse type, trabecular type. Again, both horns and diffuse. And what's the best about it? In the adult type, you see the colics in our body. And here, multiple of them. The other thing, the mothers in the ward, and the GYN oncologists, when they do fellowship, they have pathology in their ward. So one of the questions that all the fellows, they come back to me, it's like the grooves, and these are the grooves everywhere, especially in the adult. You lack that in the juvenile, you want to see it. Gyriform and water cell, all of this. Immunohistochemistry. Do I do it? Yes, we do it sometimes. Inhibin, it's only 70% positive. There are 30% you can add a negative. Okay. So what's my other plan? I do together inhibin and calreptin. Calreptin, it is more sensitive and specific. So always use both of them, inhibin and calreptin. But do I use bimantin or the CD99 and ferritin? We don't. Okay, only in the differential diagnosis. Adult versus juvenile. So as I mentioned, younger versus older, usually after 30, usually rare after 30. And the mature follicle or the calyx in our body, it is classic for the adult granulosa cell tumor, but we don't see it that much in the juvenile. In the juvenile, it is more that irregular space filled, like cystic kind of pattern filled with secretion. And luteinization, it's infrequent in the adult, and it is more common in the juvenile. And from my experience, you see the juvenile more mixed of that 6-4 stromal tumor, not only pure juvenile granulosa cell tumor, but you would see more. This is why I talked about the cystic space, irregular and filled with secretion. You see this picture more in the juvenile granulosa cell tumor than the adult. So the differential diagnosis, it could be similar to small cell carcinoma, endometrial stromal sarcoma, undifferentiated carcinoma, it can be here, cellular fibroma become, and always we think about melanoma, so you don't want to miss it. It's the great mimicker of everything. So just I throw it here because you never know. And this is in the differential diagnosis between a granulosa cell tumor and the Sertoli Leydig cell tumor. The Sertoli Leydig, so remember these are both unilateral. I cannot emphasize more about the unilateral, or let's think about sex for a stromal tumor. Okay? So both of them are unilateral. However, the age group, it varies. But the granulosa cell tumor most in the postmenopausal, Sertoli Leydig more in young patients. And the presentation, whenever you have a frozen section, call the surgeon on the other side. Is there any manifestation? Is the patient is presenting more androgenic manifestation? Ask them. How about the inhibin serum level, inhibin alpha serum level? Is it high? Is it low? I mean, they do all of this before the surgery. And most of the time, you get like, okay, unilateral and nexal mass. No history, all of us, right? But communicate, ask more questions. They'll lead you. Most of the time, they know more than us what are we dealing with. So this is what, it's wonderful to open that communication. Microfollicular, trabecular, all the variants we talked about. And here it depends about the differentiation.